To set the date and time on your planisphere, match up the outer dial, which has the months and days, with the inner dial, which has the time. So for example, if I wanted to set it to January 30th at 8 p.m., I would match up January 30 here with 8 p.m. When this is set, it should show the sky as it looks overhead on that date. To orient yourself to the night sky using the planisphere, notice that north is at the top, south is at the bottom, east is on the left, and west is on the right. You'll notice that east and west are reversed because you're supposed to use it holding it upside down as you're looking up in the sky. I find this a little bit hard to use, so the way I use it is whatever direction I'm facing, I have that part of the planisphere at the bottom. So for example, if I'm looking south, I'll hold it so that south is at the bottom, and then this would represent my southern horizon. These would be the constellations which are transiting at this time. If I hold it towards the east, this represents the eastern horizon, and these are constellations which are rising at this time. Turn it around so that west is at the bottom, and you'll see the constellations that are setting at this time. If you turn it so that you're facing north, you'll notice that here's the northern horizon, and as stars rise in the east and set in the west, they all rotate around one point on the planisphere, which is located underneath the grommet. That point represents Polaris, or the North Star, which is the point around the entire sky rotates. So notice how that star stands still and the entire sky rotates around it. That star is the end star in the Little Dipper, also called Ursa Minor, and it's very close to the North Celestial Pole. Stars on the planisphere are connected together into groups or forms called constellations. And on this planisphere, they've connected the dots for you, so you can see the constellation quite clearly. Constellations on the planisphere are labeled with all capital letters. Bright stars in those constellations are labeled with just the first letter as being capitalized. So for example, this constellation here, Bootes, has a bright star called Arcturus in it. And you can see that Arcturus is a fairly bright star because it has a very large dot. You'll also notice some other markings on the planisphere. Over here is a band of light called the Milky Way. Right? It has this mottled appearance on the planisphere. You'll notice that the celestial equator is a solid line going across here, and the ecliptic is this dashed line going through. You'll notice that some of the constellations along the ecliptic look familiar, and once you recognize their names, you'll see why this is. Now the ecliptic is the path of the sun, moon, and planets across the sky. So the sun, moon, and planets will all be found somewhere along this dashed line on the planisphere. Say you want to locate the position of the sun on a particular date. What you do is you know the sun is exactly due south at noon. So on a particular date, let's say September 1st, we'll turn around here, set it for September 1st at noon, turn it here, look up, and you'll see the sun will be right here in Leo on that date. If you want to know what time the sun rose on that date, keep your finger on there and dial the planisphere until your finger touches the eastern horizon. Then look and see what's the corresponding time of that sunrise, and it looks like it's around just before 8 a.m. So that's about right. If you want to find what time the sun sets on that date, you'll move your finger until it touches the western horizon, and then find the corresponding time for September 1st. One thing you'll notice is that stars and constellations tend to rise earlier each night. So if you take a look here on the eastern horizon, you'll notice that Leo is rising, and this is happening at midnight on December 1st. But notice that by 10 p.m. at the end of December, Leo is rising in the same place. Notice by 8 p.m. at the end of January, it's rising. And then 6 p.m. by February. So Leo is rising roughly 2 hours earlier for every month throughout the year. This corresponds to roughly 4 minutes a day. So stars and constellations will rise 4 minutes earlier the next day as they did on the day previous. This has been a short but concise introduction to how to use your star and planet locator, also called a planisphere. The best way to learn how to use it is to practice, and practice on the real night sky as much as possible. Get to know it. It's a great friend for learning constellations, what's up at any particular date and time, and how the sky moves night to night throughout the year. Okay, that's it for now. Talk to you next time.